Okay, thank you. Oh.
Comrades, we have to fight to keep our welfare state. We have to struggle to ensure our kids and grandkids benefit from an NHS and a point of free and a point of delivery. So comrades, go back to your workplaces and join the fight. Join your communities and engage in the struggle. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Our next speaker wasn't billed on the leaflets, but we've got a special treat that is available here today. He's been on the march, fresh from General Secretary election, which I'm pleased to say he was successful at. Lynn McCluskey, General Secretary of Unite.
Well, thank you, Martin. And sisters and brothers, the first thing I want to say is a huge big thank you to all of you for coming out on this day to celebrate the values of working class. Millions of people, millions of workers throughout the world today are doing exactly the same, making certain that the values of our class are still very much top of the priority within our societies, and also sending a message, a very clear message, to every government throughout this globe that we reject their austerity programme. We reject the fact that government after government is asking ordinary working people to pay for the crisis of capitalism, a crisis caused by the spivs and the speculators, a crisis caused by those who have benefited for the last 30 years of casino capitalism. Here, within the UK, we have a Conservative government who's trying to take away everything that generations of working people have fought for. It was our parents and our grandparents who, having defeated fascism at the end of the Second World War, came back determined to build a land fit for heroes, determined to banish forever the spectre of hunger of the 1930s. And they built the welfare state. They gave us the National Health Service. They created universal education, all of which is now being attacked by a bunch of posh public schoolboys. And we've got to say, we're not prepared to stand idly by and allow everything that we hold dear to be taken away from us. We must join together with a coalition of resistance, linking community groups, faith organisations, students, senior citizens, trade unions, to make certain that our voice collectively comes together. Everything should be involved in that resistance. Civil disobedience and, yes, mass industrial action needs to be implemented to stop this crowd from doing what they're doing. These type of demonstrations raise the confidence, raise the consciousness of ordinary people. And that's our role as leaders. All of us here in this square are leaders, to raise the consciousness of our class. And I'll leave you with this thought, comrades. The media, the mouthpiece of the ruling elite and the corporate giants, dismiss us. They tell us you can have as many strikes as you like. You can have as many marches as you like. It won't make any difference. It won't change what the governments are doing. They try to debilitate us. But I reject that form of defeatism. Our history, the history of the world, tells us that when working people join together, anything is possible. We've seen through the Arab Spring the fall of dictators. We even see that when Margaret Thatcher, God rest her soul, when Margaret Thatcher was at the height of her power, she was brought down by people power over the poll tax when millions came onto the streets. Tony Blair, the most popular Prime Minister according to polls, his demise can be traced back when millions of people came out onto the streets over the Iraq War and said, not in our name. So brothers and sisters, comrades and friends, have faith in your beliefs, because together we can create a better world. Thank you.